Hey, and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be looking at the Morphe Catch My Eye brush collection that came out. I'm actually not sure how long this has been out. If I figure it out, I'll link it down below. But it was on sale for Black Friday for $19 for 6 brushes, so I felt like that was a pretty good deal. And I've heard good things from other YouTubers about the quality of Morphe brushes, and I've stocked up on a couple myself. So I just figured this was a great way to get a bunch of eyeshadow brushes, because you can never have too many clean crease brushes, blending brushes, buffing brushes. So we're gonna look at that today using the Tati Beauty palette that came out a couple months ago. I've used it a couple of times, but I really wanted to play with it a little more. I've already done some of my makeup today because I wore it to work. It's wearing a little thin. I don't normally wear a lot of heavy makeup to work anyway. But that's why I've jumped the gun a little bit and already have some mascara on and then tight lined the outside of my eye. If you hear me jingling, it's because I'm wearing a Christmas sweater that I wore to work and Rudolph's nose jingles. So please don't be alarmed if you hear that. So today, let's go ahead and get started. This is the packaging that it comes in. Like I said, it's the Catch My Eye Morphe Brush Collection. It says here it's got the M167 Oval Shadow Brush, the M49 Duo Deluxe Crease Brush, the M433 Pro Firm Blending Fluff Brush, the M330 Blending Crease Brush, the M574 Pencil Crease Brush, and the M31 Bullet Crease Brush. Now, I'm pretty sure that I already have the Pro Firm Blending Fluff Brush, but we'll see. Again, if I have two, then that's really okay. I'm okay with that. But just so you can see the back of it, so maybe you can recognize the ones that you already have. When you open up the box, it comes plastic wrapped. So we'll open that pretty quickly. And then each brush is individually packaged as well, so that's really nice. Not that I think anything would come in, you know, unsanitary, but maybe if you were gonna purchase a box, you never know with a place like Ulta or Sephora if something could have been opened and returned. So it's just nice to see if these are all individually wrapped. So we're gonna get started today laying down a base layer, just like a good neutral eye color that matches my skin tone in the Tati palette to get started. So we're gonna use the M167 Oval Shadow Brush. If I can get it out of the packaging, it's this one. So I'm gonna take the Tati Beauty palette. And by the way, I'm not doing swatches on this palette because it's been out long enough now that there are plenty of other swatch videos if you wanna see it. But we're gonna take Aura down here in the matte shadow line. We're just gonna tap it in. Now this is a pretty fluffy palette, so you are gonna wanna tap off the excess so that way you don't have fallout everywhere in your eye. And we're just gonna pack it in. I did put concealer on before I started this adventure, but that was 20 minutes ago. So we'll see how well this packs on and how well you can actually see this color in these lights, because I am a pasty pale human. Okay, so this one I think is a really good just like concealer shade to pack on. Again, tapping off the excess. You can see there was quite a bit of fallout, but these shadows are so soft and easy to work with that I really don't mind the fallout. But if you're somebody who doesn't like the extra mess, like I could see how that would bother you. And that's a pretty consistent review. That's not something that I just came from my brain. That's something that a lot of other YouTubers have had a similar experience with. I will say the shadow is very pigmented. I had some some eyeliner that had gotten up on my eyelid and that covered it up right away. So I think that that's great that these are so pigmented. And this brush is laying it down pretty nice. I normally wouldn't use such a tiny brush for this. Let me see if I can find one I normally use. I normally use some Real Techniques brushes. So I usually use like a fluffier brush like this. You can actually see I cleaned all these, but it's still a little bit stained from before. But we're gonna do with what we have because that's the purpose of this video. So now that we've laid down the concealer shade, let's go in with a full fluffy crease brush. I don't think I'm gonna use the Duo Deluxe crease brush. I think instead I am going to use this blending crease brush, the M330, to lay down our crease shade. Or there's this blending brush, but I think we'll use that in a little bit. So I'm gonna go in with Soothe in the matte shades, right here. If you're a darker skinned person, I would probably use even something like Ritual or Story in your crease line. But like I said, I'm pretty pale. So we're just gonna start in the outer corner. Wherever you start first is where the most pigment is gonna be put down. So even if you're like blending it out appropriately, you're always gonna have a little bit darker on the outside. So I don't want all the deep color like starting right here and being the most concentrated. So I'm gonna start towards the outer part of my eye and then just move back and forth like this, going in a couple more times, really building it up. Sorry, I'm getting so close to this camera. It's just reflex to move a little bit closer in. Bring it down just a little bit into my eye. I do have hooded eyes, so if I just leave it strictly in the crease, you're not gonna see it. That color payoff's not gonna be there when my eyes are open. Obviously, when my eyes are closed, you can see more of it, but I have not quite gotten comfortable with really intense eye looks yet. Like I said, I just wear it to my desk job every day. I rarely get super glammed and go out. So I'm not quite comfortable yet doing really deep smoky eyes. And when I say comfortable, I mean I'm comfortable creating them. I'm not comfortable wearing them out. So you're going to see this is probably more of like a neutral 9-to-5 job type look, which is great for like an everyday get out and go look. I like these two shades that I've put down because they make me feel like I could put these on, go to work, and look like I've put in some effort. I'm gonna go ahead with Story, this matte shade right here, and put just a little bit in that crease as well because I think it's a really pretty color. And I wanna use just a little bit of these deep pinks in a little bit. And you can see instantly the color pay off with that color. So this is not one that you need to go heavy-handed in to get the kind of color payoff that you want. There is a possibility that my husband comes home in the middle of this video, so if that happens, please just ignore the noise. I may even cut it out depending on what I'm saying at the moment that he comes home, but we'll see. Maybe you'll get to meet him. We do also have 4 dogs and 2 cats, so there's always a good possibility that you're gonna hear animal noises in the background as well. Okay, I'm gonna buff that out a little bit more with this blending fluffing brush here in a minute, but I wanted to go ahead and get that laid down. So we're gonna go ahead and darken our outer corner. I think I'm gonna do a blend of Ritual, that deep brown shade, and a little bit of the pink. The last time I wore it, my husband told me that I looked like I had a red eye and that it was angry and irritated, and then I had somebody else told me that they loved it. So maybe pink is just not gonna be my shade, but we will see. Like I said, I'm gonna go in a little bit with Ritual right now. The M574 brush, the pencil crease brush. Just a little bit, oh, let's tap off the excess and just a little bit of Poet. See what we think. And I'm gonna tap that in right where I want it on my eye, and then we'll blend it out. I feel like I should have some music going for you guys. Maybe that'll be a thing in future videos. I'm still learning how to YouTube, friends. I'm not sure that this will ever turn anything more than a hobby, but I like to play in so much products. I impulse buy all kinds of sets and mascaras and eyeshadow palettes that I just thought, even if it never goes anywhere, if I have any other friends of mine that do the same thing that are dangerous, just walking into a Sephora or Ulta, that they will also get to see it. I have another job that I'm very happy with that I have no intention of leaving. So even if this never takes off and it's just a hobby, that's fine with me. I'm okay with it. Okay, so I've laid down that color. I want to buff it out just a little bit further out on each side. This is a good starting point. I'm going to take that color and go right under my eye as well. Bring it under. Does anybody else get like super self-conscious when you realize you're on video about like the types of faces that you make when you apply mascara? You're focusing really hard on your eye makeup? Or is it just me? Probably not. Probably not just me. I've seen Tati and Rachel both get, Rachel loves both get really self-conscious about it on camera. So, well, it's just as women, we're just gonna have to be okay with it. Or men, you know, you can make funny faces too. Okay. So we're gonna take, oh gosh, I'm not really sure which of these brushes I would wanna use. We have the Pro Firm Blending Brush and we have the Duo Deluxe Crease Brush. I'm gonna use the blending brush, obviously, because that's what it says. I'll show you the type of brush I would normally use, but since I really wanted to get a feel for the quality of these brushes today, I wanted to just use these. Say that now in all of my brushes over here, I cannot find them. Anyway, I have another Real Technique brush that's a little bit more rounded. Oh, here it is, that I like to buff out with. I've had it so long that the number is gone, so if I can find it on their website, I will link it down below so you can find it. So we're just gonna go and kind of pull this out a little bit, buff it out and down, because again, I have hooded eyes, so if I don't bring it out, you're not gonna see it, it's gonna be gone. So you could tell already if you look at this eye, this one's a little more smoked out, it's been brought out a little further. The colors aren't as intense in one spot. This is open, closed, so you can see there's a big difference in color, which is why I wanted to bring it out some so you could see it. And we're gonna do the other side just the same way. Pull it out a little further, buff out the colors, blend them well. And then I'm gonna go in with either the metallic or the sequined shade in the Tati Beauty palette, just to add a little pop of color. There's just a little bit of fallout under here. I wouldn't normally probably do my under eye concealer first. But like I said, I put on concealer and a powder for work this morning, as well as lipstick. We had our holiday party, and so here we are. Okay, so let's go in for these sequin shades or the metallic shades. I'm gonna go ahead and pop them in. I did try out the glitter shades, this top row, using a wet brush. I actually, a lady at Ulta recommended a brush for it rather than using my hands. And I tried it and I've just found that they tend to fall apart when I use it like that. And maybe that's just a user error, but I'm gonna, if I were to use these glitter shades in the top row, I would probably just tap them on with my finger. So we're gonna do the same thing with the metallics. I wanna hit my inner corner just a little bit with Aura in the metallic row right here. Maybe we'll do the sequin shade instead. Yeah, that's better. And I'm tapping, tap, 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 tap. Right here again. Then I'm gonna take the metallic Aura shade and pop that in right here. Just for an extra pop of color. Tap, tap, tap. I do have to tell you, as far as like videos I'm looking forward to making, I have four dogs, like I mentioned, and they're Shiba Inus, and I cannot wait to make a, like, just a video about them talking to each other, because they talk all the time, and they have the cutest noses. Okay, so this is the finished look. Normally I would go ahead and add a liner to it, but since I tight lined today, I don't think I want to do, like, a liquid eyeliner look or anything like that. I am gonna go ahead and touch up my mascara. I've been really loving the Pat McGrath FetishEyes mascara. So I'm gonna go ahead and touch that up just in case I got any shadow on it. I don't normally wear fake lashes because I have my own very naturally long lashes. I like to really wiggle it up and make sure I'm getting the base coat or all the way down to the base well. Because while I have really long lashes, I wouldn't say that they're very voluminous. And so I think it's really important to have a mascara for me that I can really wiggle into the base. So that's that for today. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you want to know what you can look forward to in future videos, I'm going to be reviewing two additional things that I have next to me. I got this kit for the holidays. It's the Drunk Elephant, the MIDI Committee. It's got the proteiny polypeptide cream, the retinol cream. It's got the B Hydra Intensive Hydration Serum, the Slay Makeup Melting Butter Cleanser, and the Bamboo Booster Exfoliant. When I got a facial the last time, she mentioned that I had a lot of blackheads that she was having a hard time getting out. So it was really important that I be exfoliating more often. So I'm gonna use this for a couple of weeks and then talk about my experiences with it. I also pretty much buy this every year. It's the Sephora Favorites mascaras. It's got two full sizes and then I think eight deluxe sizes. It's normally $48 with a value of $135. But I got it on sale Black Friday again, I think for $39. So $39 for two deluxe mascaras and a set of lashes is crazy in and of itself. And then you've got the eight deluxes on top of that. I think that's fantastic. I'll do a video on these as well where I test them out, maybe over a couple of different days so I can really give them a fair test. And then I also just got the Halo Beauty HERS multivitamin in. I've been taking a prenatal, not because we're trying for a baby at the moment, but because of all the different vitamins it does have in it, by Pink Stork. So we're gonna kind of compare those and see how I feel on them and really maybe do like a side-by-side review. So if you're looking forward to those videos, stay tuned. They'll be up in the next couple of weeks. Thank you so much for tuning in. Like, subscribe, help me out. Keep following me if you wanna see somebody who's not a professional makeup artist, who's just here to hopefully tell her friends what she's trying out too, and follow me on this journey. Thanks again, happy holidays.